we are going to find either voltage and or current for a particular circuit or particular element. Puridha? So what there are so many methods are available now by using nodal analysis we can calculate current and voltage and power, and by using mesh analysis we can calculate voltage power, and by using Thevenin's theorem also we are going to find voltage and current, isn't it? So to find out voltage and current there are so many methods are used. Then what is the difference between the previous one, that is mesh and nodal analysis and Thevenin and Norton's theorem? Is in Thevenin and Norton's theorems we are not using the load, that is we are not considering the load resistance. Without considering the load resistance we are going to find RTH and VTH, isn't it? Without considering the load resistance, that is we are not considering the load, but we are going to calculate the parameter of the load. That is the main thing. Puridha? So to find any one of, suppose in a practical network, in a practical circuit, suppose the circuit is very big or complex circuit. So on that case, we are not considering the load. That is, load may be a very heavy load. We are not considering the load, but we are going to calculate the parameter of the load. That is the very important thing by using Thevenin's and Norton's theorem. Okay, wow. So here that is similar to that is previous calculation. Once we are going to designing any circuit, we are assuming we are designing a circuit for a particular application or for a particular load. We are designing a circuit for rotating the fan, or we are designing a circuit for any tuned circuit, whatever it is. So for any amplifier, so we are going to design a circuit for some other applications. Then we are not having, that is we know the load value, that is we know the load parameter as well as we know the circuit value, but there is no need of considering. We are not using a load directly, load use panna avasiyam illa, but we know the load resistance value as well as we know the circuit value. So without using the load we can calculate the voltage and current of the load. That is very important. So load e illama and the loaded parameter kandupidikkuram, that means in Norton's theorem. Okay va? So here Norton's, in Thevenin's theorem what are the rules that we are going to follow? There are, in Thevenin's theorem we are going to find two parameters, Thevenin resistance and Thevenin voltage. In Thevenin resistance, there is a Thevenin voltage in series with Thevenin resistance. That is called as Thevenin equivalent circuit. Thevenin equivalent circuit consists of a voltage source in series with a current source. Sorry, resistance. This resistance is Thevenin resistance, Thevenin voltage. Then this is the equivalent circuit. See, in this case, suppose we are using load to find the current. Okay, at last we are using the load. The same, and that is before that we are going to find VTH and RTH. What is the procedure to find VTH?
Remove the
load resistance. Then any other steps? So to find VTH, just we are going to remove the load resistance and find out the VTH. Then what about the procedure to find RTH?
Remove the load resistance.
Open circuit.
Current source.
Network, you are going to short circuit. That means once you are short circuiting the voltage value becomes zero. When you are open circuit, under open circuit condition, what about the current?
Zero.
Open circuit current will be
zero.
Zero. Short circuit voltage will be
zero.
So that is, we are going to make the source become inactive, or so the source become zero. So that's why we can say that voltage source should be short circuited and current source should be open circuited. Okay, va? Now we are going to, that is the Thevenin's equivalent circuit consists of Thevenin voltage in series with Thevenin resistance. Then in Norton circuit the same procedure, that is in any linear bilateral network can be reduced to a Norton current parallel with Norton resistance. Norton resistance means that is equivalent to Thevenin resistance. Okay, wow. Norton current source it states that in any linear bilateral network consists of elements, active and passive elements, then it can be replaced by a current source, not a current parallel with not a resistance, or in some book it is represented by RTH, whatever it is, because both are equal, not a resistance and thevenin resistance, both are equal, not a current parallel with not a resistance, then here we are going to use. So this is the equivalent circuit of Norton resistance. Okay, va? In Norton theorem, current source parallel with the resistance. In Thevenin's theorem,
voltage source
series with the resistance. Now in Norton's theorem, current source parallel with the resistance. In Thevenin's theorem, voltage source series with the resistance. Now one more thing that you must know, then how do you convert voltage source into current source? Suppose a voltage source is given in your circuit, in our circuit, so it can be, that is voltage source, we can replace, isn't here, we can replace the voltage source in series with the resistance, can be replaced by, that is it can be converted into current source parallel to the resistance. We are all know one formula, what is Ohm's law? Is equal to I into R. Suppose the voltage source, this is called as voltage source, source transformation technique. Source transformation means we are going to convert one source into other source. Source na ila ila source number chukko? Source na voltage source into current source. Voltage source and current source. So voltage source transformation. How do you convert voltage source into current source and current source into voltage source? Then what is the current, what condition we are going to convert it? Prida, eppa nam convert pannala, what is the condition? Ella we are not convert ella condition voltage source current source convert panna mudiyadhu illaya. So what is the condition? So whenever the voltage source is in series with the resistance, it can be converted into current source parallel with the resistance. Able to understand? So whenever a circuit consists of, wherever a circuit consists of a voltage source in series with the resistance, is can be converted into current source parallel with the resistance. Suppose I am giving one voltage source, this is the value is 50 volt, whatever it is, and the resistance value is 5 ohms. Suppose if you are finding like this, this is voltage source series with the resistance. This is equal to this voltage source can be converted into current source parallel with the resistance. Current source means negative to positive, so the arrow mark should be like this. Suppose if it is negative and if it is positive, the arrow mark should be downwards. Okay, va? So here the arrow mark should be upwards and current source parallel with the resistance. The resistance value is 5 ohm. What is I is equal to? V by R. What is the value of V? 50. 50 by 5? 10 amps. So the current source is 10 amps. Able to understand? The current source is the only convert panna mudiyadhu. Voltage source la parallel resistance la convert panna mudiyadhu. Eppa convert panna adina? Whenever the voltage source is in series with the resistance, can be converted into current source parallel with the resistance. Purinjuda? In the same manner, the current source is given. Suppose the current source is given parallel with the resistance value is 5 ohm, 50 amps. Okay, va? This can be converted into voltage source. How? What is the value of voltage? Voltage source. Again, for the resistance. Resistance, if you know. Series. Series with the resistance. Resistance value, you know. What is the value of resistance?
5
ohm. What is the value of voltage? V is equal to I into R. Again, how?
250.
Is it right or wrong?
Wrong.
5.
Downwards, downwards.
The current is in?
Downwards.
Upward.
So,
downwards.
Positive.
This is negative and this is? Okay, Vapurinjana. So, it depends on the direction you have to mark like this. Punjana. So, we will take a source transformation technique. The title is source. That is, this is very, it is not given in your syllabus, but this concept is very, very important to solve the problem. Prida, the concept is very, very important. Source transformation. Don't talk. Mobile is going to be a lot of mobile. Silent. Theorem states that a linear bilateral network consists of active and passive sources can be replaced with the can be reduced with the a simple network Norton's current parallel with the Norton's resistance. So this is called as Norton's theorem. Note down the problem. Find current I. Find current I flowing through. Find current I flowing through 1 ohm resistance by applying Norton's theorem. Show you rub it. Have you all copied? Thank you.
9 R and how do you redraw the circuit? Short circuit the voltage source and open circuit the current source, then remove the
load.
So which one is load resistance?
1 ohm
is load resistance. We are going to remove the load resistance. Okay, ma'am. Then short circuit the voltage source. Correct value.
is equal to I R. I is equal to
V by R.
V by R. 2 by 2.
1
amp. So this is an upward direction or downward direction? Agar mark. Upward direction. This one. Again, this one. Voltage source seems to be the resistance. Can be replaced with current source parallel resistance. Current source parallel to the resistance. Resistance value is
2 ohms.
2 ohms. The current value is
1.5
amps. The direction is the upward or downward?
Upward.
Upward direction. Again, here we have IN. This is IN. Here again, 1 amps. Able to understand this one? Boys, purinjada illaya? Purida. Just I am going to transfer this voltage source into current source. Here, transfer the voltage source into current source. How many nodes are there in the circuit? It is a node.
Point.